Welcome to Everyday Life of Ralph Powers. Welcome to Everyday Life of Ralph Powers. Welcome to Everyday Life of Ralph Powers.
Got a possible railroad crossing malfunction down here. Oh, there could be a train coming. I keep my camcorder on me at all times, and for situations like this. There's no train in sight. Guess I'll see one. Thank you. about you, but that's awesome. Fortunately, no train. That probably was just a malfunction or something. It would be nice to see actual train in here.
Today of Monday, June 16th, 2014, celebrates the 25th anniversary of Ghostbusters 2.
increasing the temperature in the room. It's up to 95 degrees at the moment. Now my assistant is asking if they'd mind waiting another half hour. Oh, good. Very good. Very nice.
So, Egan, what do you think?
Excellent. Just excellent. You know the happiness index next?
I mean, about the carriage.
Well, I'd like to bring Ray in on this, if you don't mind.
Sure, what do you think? But nothing.
Oh, no.
Do you ever see him?
Occasionally.
How is he these days?
Peter? Well, he was borderline for a while. Then he crossed the border.
Does he ever mention me?
No.
Well, we didn't part on very good terms, and then we sort of lost track of each other after I got married.
We're ready for the affection test.
Good, send him the puppy, please.
I thought of getting in touch with him after my marriage ended, but... Isn't that sweet? I appreciate you doing this.
Try not to worry.
Here's my phone number. You'll call me?
Yes.
I'd rather you didn't mention any of this to Peter, if you don't mind.
No, I won't. Let's see what happens when we take away the puppy. This GI.
So I think I'm Peter Baker. I'm chatting with my guest, author, lecturer, and psychic, Milton Anglin. Milton, your new book is called The End of the World. Now, can you tell us when it's going to be, or do we have to buy the book?
Well, I predict that the world will end at the stroke of midnight on New Year's Eve.
This year?
Mm-hmm.
Well, that's cutting it a little bit close, isn't it? I mean, just from a sales point of view, I mean, your book is just coming out. You're not going to see any paperback sales for at least a year. It'll be at least another year before you know whether you've got that miniseries or a movie of the week kind of possibility. I mean, just devil's advocate, Milty. I mean, shouldn't you have said, hey, the world's going to end in 1992, or better yet, 1994?
This is not just some money-making scheme, all right? I have a strong psychic belief that the world will end on New Year's Eve.
Well, for your sake, I hope you're right. Okay, but I think my other guest may disagree with you.
Elaine, now you have another date.
According to my source, the end of the world will be on February 14th in the year 2006. My husband. It was in the Paramus Holiday Inn. I was having a drink at the bar alone, and this alien approached me. He started talking to me. He bought me a drink, and then I think he must have used some kind of a ray or a mind control device because he forced me to follow him to his room, and that's right. He told me about the end.
So your alien had a room at the Holiday Inn, perhaps?
It might have been a room on the spacecraft made up to look like a room at the Holiday Inn. I can't be sure about that.
Of course not. And that is the whole problem with aliens, is you just can't trust them. Occasionally you meet a nice one, Starman, E.T., but usually they turn out to be some kind of big lizard. That's all the time we've got for this week on World of the Psychic. Next week, though. Yeah, hairless pets. Until then, this is Peter Benton saying. See you then. Years, it's your first parole hearing. They'll never take us alive.
All right, let's get on with it.
Your Honor,
ladies and gentlemen of the audience. I don't think it's fair to call my clients frauds. Okay, so the blackout was a big problem for everybody, okay? I was stuck in an elevator for 2 hours and I had to make the whole time. But I don't blame them. This one time I turned into a dog and they helped me. Thank you.
Very good, Lewis. Short but pointless.
Mr. Fianella, please look at exhibits A through F on the table over here. Do you recognize this equipment?
Yeah, this is something not put in their truck.
Do you know what this equipment is used for?
I don't know. Can't you post it?
May I remind the court that the defendants are under a judicial restraining order that strictly forbids them from performing services as paranormal investigators or eliminators?
So noted.
Now, Mr. Fianella, can you identify the substance in this jar marked Exhibit F?
Yeah, that's the stuff for you. Your Honor, I've been working underground for Continent for 27 years. I never saw anything like this in my life.
Mm.
Whatever's down there, they must have poured it there.
No, we didn't!
Shut up!
So you were just trying to help out a friend who was scared of what was happening to her. When you're scared, what?
There was no evil.
There was no evil intended, no malice. Because you live here, when you live in a place and you love it like you do, you don't want nothing bad to happen. What? Because it'll never happen again. It's an isolated incident. It's a one-shot deal.
Objection, Your Honor.
What?
He's leading the witness.
Same. Mr. Tully, are there any questions for this witness? May I have some bearing on this case?
Do I?
No, we've helped them out enough already.
No, Your Honor. Your witness.
Bateman, would you please tell the court why it is that you and your co-defendants took it upon yourselves to dig a very big hole in the middle of First Avenue?
Well, there's so many holes in First Avenue, we really didn't think anyone would notice.
Keep that up, mister. I'll find you in contempt.
I'm truly sorry, Your Honor.
I'll ask you again, Dr. Bateman, why were you digging a hole? And please remember, you're under oath.
There are some things in this world that go way beyond human understanding. Things that cannot be explained. Things that most people don't want to know about. That is where we...
So what you're saying is that the world of the supernatural is your exclusive province?
Kitten, I think what I'm saying is that sometimes shit happens,
Peter Beckman, Raven Stans, Egon Spengler. Stand up! Get up! You too, Mr. Tully. Find you guilty on all charges. Or do you pay fines in the amount of $25,000 each? You're sentenced 18 months in the city correctional facility in Rikers Island.
She's twitching.
I'm not finished! On the more personal note, let me just go on record as saying that no place fakes charlatans.
Your Honor?
Shut up! Tricksters like you in decent society.
Your Honor, this is important.
You play the gullibility of innocent people.
Yes, sir.
Be quiet.
What?
I am uncalled for offenders of the law. The American most distinction of our illustrious office. Great crap. You have the courage to turn our justice and have you.
Talk to my attorney.
And that's me! My guys are still under a judicial estrangement order. That blue thing I got from her. They could be exposing themselves.
And you don't want us exposing ourselves.
rules.
Order! Action the order! Kids dismissed!
Sorry, we have the keys!
Now do something!
Oh, I always hate this part of the business.
You know, it's been a couple of years since we used this stuff. I hope it still works.
It should. Power cells have a half-life of 5,000 years. There's no time for a bench test. Heat them up.
Go. Ray.
He gone.
Ralph. Ghostbusters.
Ghostbusters!
Haven't we all gone mad?
I guess so, Pete, because that's not all. Tell them, Egon.
Oh, you mean the Ghostbusters hot beverage thermal mug and free balloons for the kids?
Go! What?
They're experimenting with the plasma we found in the subway tunnel. Careful.
Should I get spoons? Don't bother. Watch this.
Go ahead, Ray.
You! You worthless piece of lawn! You ignorant, disgusting clod!
An unstable short chain molecule.
You foul, obnoxious moth!
You have a weak electrochemical bond.
I have seen some disgusting crud in my time, but you,
this is what you do with your spare time, Peter. This is an incredible breakthrough. I mean, what a discovery! A psychoreactive substance. Whatever this stuff is, it responds to human emotional states. Mood slime.
Oh, baby.
You mean this stuff actually feeds on bad vibes?
Like a cop in a donut factory.
We've been running tests to see if we can get an equally strong positive reaction.
What kind of test? Well, we sing to it, and we talk to it. Say supportive, nurturing things to it.
You're not sleeping.
These quiet ones.
You know. How about the kinetic test?
Okay.
Ordinary household toaster.
We'll take your word for that. It responds to music, so we've been doing some experimentation. Plain easy listening, little rotary stuff, you know, Paul Young, gust in the wind. That works okay. Works for me.
Love tech. You guys do this at night when I'm not here?
Oh, I get it. It sings. It sounds exactly like Jack. That's fantastic.
Just watch.
Does it do any of the hair?
Your love!
Oh, Jesus!
First time somebody gets mad, the Tolson could eat their hand.
No. We put a warning label on it. We don't have any liability.
Ah! Ow! How did you ever go for it?
The old man in the toaster. Ah! Hello?
Somebody get me the Ghostbusters.
Wants it on the 21st century. He needs a human body to inhabit. The locks are the end.
Yeah, I bet we're the only ones who can do anything about it.
You bet we are.
Living God. Sure, they give magnificent apartment, car, apartment.
many marriages begin with a certain amount of distance. I think it helps you and I could learn to love each other.
Yes. I could learn.
Stuff.
McNuggets in her side, Frank.
Oh, don't worry, she's tough. She's a Harvard chick!
New York. Tasty pick. Bonehead. if you had 3-1 in that huge melon on top of your head, you would be living the sweet life out in Southern California's beautiful San Fernando Valley.
Too cold to hold. called the Ghostbusters and the end control. Had a throwing party for a bunch of children. Well, all the while, the slime was under the building. So they banged up and built.